Holy crap, look at this truck. It's just covered in limestone. It's just caked on there. Let's check this ECM out. This truck is scrap. She's really rough. Ugh. Gets all over everything. I'm out of practice. I do this all the time in the winter, right? But I'm not accustomed to it. Usually I'm fighting through. Well, yeah, in the 8 mils, but usually that plastic just comes right up and off, so you can just take a look at the numbers before I even bother with it. But I should be able just to peel off. It'll take 2 seconds. I got my trusty maximum set here, and got that axle shaft or input blower shaft as well with me. So yeah, look at, oh man, this is, the seat is all horrible.
Yeah, she's had a rough life.
Yeah, she's had a rough life, all right. Look at this seat. This is like the Ritchie Brothers auction I was just at. There's like, oh boy. Hilarious. Oh, hey, grab that. I could use that. Wow. Okay, well, here she is. People had said, why don't I just read the serial numbers off of this engine? Well, look at this. It's all covered in feces, all in there, all up and around there on top of the engine. Anyways, this is where you have to read the numbers. Can you read that? I can't see that. 4D31 something. I can't make out the rest, but yeah, very difficult to read, and it's all covered in poop. Look at all that there. Anyways, I thought that there'd be snow the next time I showed up here. So anyways, I'll just put this new shaft on here. I'm glad that it got me up and running again, and then just gotta return the new one. So the shaft was brand new. I'm probably guessing it's made in China, but anyways, the guy didn't care if it was new, used, or whatever, just as long as he got a replacement one. So yeah, so I got it shipped to the United States. I got it shipped to Michigan for $18, and it came all the way from Miami. So I lucked out on that. To ship it right to Rodney was $100. I was like, that's ridiculous. So anyways, see if this can fit back in. There we go. This has to line up. Must not have it lined up there. This has to fit right. So, and then finally, after emailing other companies, then they finally get back to me as soon as I get another one. Got the 9/16 ray, got the retainer clip, and then I gotta put those two clamps back on those on the rubbers. Okay, well, I just wanted to go over a couple things as I'm finishing up this Detroit diesel. Well, they're just about got her loaded up over there. A Dodge truck, and then they had a cab from a van. Anyways, why would you need an underspeed governor? Wouldn't you want an overspeed governor? I just can't figure that out. And the speed rating's for 3,300, and that is driven off of the... that's driven right off of the shaft here for the blower input. Now, something else that I find interesting is, in order to shut down this engine, it has the flap that gets flipped up, and it shuts off the oxygen to getting into the intake. So anyways, mine doesn't do that. I cut the fuel off by the fuel, like I pull the pedal up all the way. So it doesn't use the air to cut off the engine, it uses the actual fuel and just cuts off the fuel to shut down the engine. So anyways, that's one difference between this one and mine. Another thing is notice the RPM gauge goes to 2500. Now, these are two-stroke engines. So just like your string trimmer or weed whacker, whatever you want to call it, this is a two-stroke diesel. So as it needs this blower in order to run. It has to force air into the cylinders in order to run, and it has to blow the air out of the cylinders as well when it's trying to run as well. So in order to make this run, it needs that input shaft to run. That's why I couldn't just run it. I noticed one dumb comment that got flagged as spam, but anyways, yeah, what I'm trying to say is that this makes all its RPMs and all its power at the high end of the RPM scale, not at the low end. Just like your string trimmer makes lots of power at the top, it's because it's a two-stroke engine. So anyways, I just wanted to stress that enough that the T-Rex, that's why I call it the T-Rex, is because it's just screaming. It's a screaming Jimmy engine. Look at this beautiful car. It's not every day you see a nice old Oldsmobile, a Moldsmobile. Has Derby written all over it. Look at this thing. Ooh, nice. An old Delta 88. And then check out this old girl. Man, I'm just, well, I got her all loaded up there. That looks like a good full load. Check out this old girl. Not every day you see this old stuff. I'm really taking a liking to this stuff. I think it's really unique, and they're really cool for projects and stuff like that, you know. Oh yeah, that's pretty cool. Oh, nice. Nice and rusty. I mean, what do you expect? I mean, it's old, ancient stuff. It's got a wood floor there. Looks like someone has patched it before. And some old brake shoes. Right on. Yeah, it's really cool to see these old girls. Even got the key still left in it. So it's an old Dodge. Yeah, old Dodge. Yeah, I'm starting to really like these old machines. They sure don't make them like they used to. Yeah, back then things were so simple. Look at this horn here. And then look at the nice flat top there. And there's your oil breather. Spark plugs all go through a tube. Honeycomb rad. Then you got your simple carburetor, sight bowl for your fuel filter. Things were a lot different back then. A lot different. More inefficient, but a lot simpler. Yeah, this looks like a good one. Look at all that limestone, eh?
You know how much weight that adds to scrap?
Oh boy. Wow. Yeah, that would add a lot of weight to the scrap. Like a rock.